Hi, it's your friendly neighborhood VTuber Suvi here again with a new tutorial. So, today we're gonna continue from the 3D room tutorial series, and I'm gonna show you guys how to add screen capture functionality, a bit like what you see behind me there on the screen. For this tutorial, you will still need the VCFace SDK, as well as a new component called UWindow Capture. I will show where to download this, so do not worry. But before you get into this tutorial, I recommend you check the previous tutorials to see how to build the room basics. But you can also do this without a room setup. Anyway, if you're ready, let's get started. Okay, so the first step for us is to download the UWindow Capture asset package. And you can do this by going to the address in the description, and then scrolling all the way to the version 0.6.0 or whichever version VCFace supports at that specific time you're doing this. And when you arrive here, open up the assets and then simply click on the Unity package and download that somewhere on your hard drive. Okay, so now that we have our Unity project open and we have our room setup open, we can start to build this. Now, if you do not have a room setup, I recommend you follow the previous two tutorials to create this first. Now, if you don't want to do this, of course, you can do it without your room. Okay, so the first thing we are going to do is we need to drag in the new asset we just downloaded. So just drag that into your Unity project and import all the files and let Unity process for a bit. Now, the first thing we want to do is add a new scene node, and this will be outside our model. So we're simply going to create to the root of the hierarchy, and we're going to call it UWindow Capture. And this node will be containing our UWindow Capture Manager. Now, the reason we're putting it outside our model is because we do not need to export this with our model, and it is only used for testing purposes, so we will actually see the screen capture working inside the Unity application. So we want to add a UVC Manager script here. So click on the Add component, and then let's search for UVC. And then let's go all the way until we find the UVC Manager. Click that one and add it. Now these default settings here are fine for us, so just keep them that way. Okay, so now that we have the manager in place, we can actually start to add the monitors here. So in our case, we're just going to put them into the room setup. If you're not using a room setup, you can add it basically to any mesh object on your screen. So to make this look nice, I'm simply going to add a few computers on the scene, and then I'm going to add the effector. So first, let's create that quickly out of the way. Okay, now that we have a computer screen available here, let's start to add the actual capture thing. So to do this, we are going to create a new empty quad. So right click on wherever you want to add it, then 3D object, and then simply find the quad. And now this creates an empty quad. So let's position it to where we want the image to appear. Like so. Now, do notice, of course, that the aspect ratio may be incorrect in this case, but UWindow Capture supports automatic resizing based on that, so we will be using that to fix some of the issues. Okay, so the next thing we need to do is add a new component to our quad. So let's do that next. So simply go to the add component, and then we are going to look for UVC window texture. So click that one and add it here. Now this is where we can apply all these settings needed for this. Now UVC capture is mostly meant for capturing specific windows. But we have also a workaround to use this to capture the whole desktop. Now there are few ways to do this. You could select desktop from here. But sadly, at least I have personally noticed that if I select the desktop, I will not be able to specify which desktop I want to capture. So in my case, this has never worked too well. So instead of doing it like this, I'm going to be capturing the so-called desktop window. And to do this, we need to actually go to the partial window title. And what we're going to type here is like this. So /// dot and then another /, and then we simply type display, and then in my case I'm going to type display 1. It can be anything from display 1 to display 2, maybe even display 0, I'm not entirely sure. You will need to try out which one makes it show up for you. And next we can click the create child windows off. This is not needed in our case. And then we can specify the frame rate. Now do notice the higher this is, the more your application will require resources. 30 is fine if you want to use it only for some like a small monitor somewhere in the corner that doesn't really need to show any details. But if you make like a big projector screen that is meant for streaming of games or showing of videos and such, then you may want to set it all the way to 60. So just to test this out, let's set it to 60. And then you can set whether to capture the cursor on the screen or not. Let's keep it visible here. And then comes the scale part. Now here you can choose different scale settings. In our case, since we kind of have it fit here, we could set it to manual, which would make it so that the image gets kind of like squeezed into the current shape. Or alternatively, we could lock one of the axes and let the component scale the other axis. Since we're kind of happy with the height, and it's probably gonna be so that our screen is wider than in this one, so let's set it to fixed width instead, like so. And now you can actually test this out by clicking the play button, and then you will see whether it works or not. So let's click play. We can move closer, and as you can see, we have image here. But of course the image is completely upside down and something else like that. So what we need to do now is figure out how to position this window. So let's turn it around a little bit. So in our case, it was actually completely mirrored, so we need to do something else than just fix the coordinates. We need to make it so that this image is rendered on both sides. The other issue we have here is that the image was very dark. So to fix this, we will probably want to change to a different kind of shader for this. So let's exit the play mode. And we're gonna reset these settings. So set the rotation back to 0. And now let's find a shader that we would like to use for this. And to do this, we need to create a new material. So right-click somewhere in your project where you want to create the material and simply go create and then material. Like so. And now we're gonna choose a different shader. Now since we are very used to the M-Toon shader, let's use that for this one as well. So let's simply search for M-Toon. Like so. And we're gonna set the cull mode to off. Like so. And next, we are going to assign this material to the quad. So select the quad, drag in this material to the material slot, like so. And let's try clicking play again and see what happens this time. And as you can see, our image is still flipped around. But this time it looks like it is not mirrored, so we should be able to just rotate it around. Like so. And that looks pretty good at the moment. Of course, as you can see, because of a widescreen monitor, it doesn't really fit in this specific prefab too well. So when you're creating your prefabs, you might want to get something that actually might work with a widescreen monitor. Okay, so now that we found the correct position for our model, we can simply copy this value. So right click on the transform and copy component. And now we exit the play mode and then right click again on the transform and pass the component values, like so. So since the texture was also not really bright enough, we could always use a different kind of shader for this. So let's try setting this to one of the shaders that came with the U-window capture. So go to the U-window capture and find the unlit texture. And now set the culling off again. And let's try with this now. This should be super bright in the scene. And as you can see, it is pretty bright. So this should work for most of those cases when you just want to make the screen visible enough. If you want to use it as a just kind of like a furniture and not really focus on it, then you can of course use some kind of more stylish lighting or something. The next thing you could try, of course, if you do not have the correct screen here, is select this one and change the display number to something else. Now, this does not update right away, so you need to go to the game view and then back to the scene view, and then it will update to the other monitor. So once you have found the correct monitor, you are basically done and you can export this model to VC Phase and then see how it works there. So again, let's click our model, then go to the VSF SDK and export avatar bundle. So if everything worked correctly, you should have the screen capture working in VC Phase. And as you can see, it captures the screen. Now, if it does show the wrong screen, you will need to, of course, export it again. I highly recommend that you add a new asset for all your monitors in case you have multiple monitors. So in case the display number changes between, let's say, your computer reboot or your when you turn on and off your monitors, you might want to have them all available here, so you don't need to export your model again. I hope this tutorial was useful for you, but remember that you can also use this component to capture specific windows and not just the whole desktop. But that is up to you, of course, to decide what you want to be capturing. Anyway, if you enjoyed the content, consider subscribing down below, as well as smashing that bell button and following me on all those other social medias as well. I do have a Discord server as well if you would like to join our comfy little community and ask any questions there. Or I do also stream on Mondays, Thursdays and Saturdays on Twitch if you would like to pop into the stream and ask any questions live. That is totally fine as well. Anyway guys, see you next time. Bye bye!